Guys, and welcome back to this new video. I'm Skill2K, and guess what? I've been contacted by the creator of this fantastic game. I've run an eye over it. I think it's fantastic. This is just a first impression. So let's just discover it together. It's very promising. So this is Lost Campus. Let's go. New game. English. Oh, wait. Preference. Well, lower a bit the music volume. I think this is nice. You can still hear me. Okay, I can close it. That was a long trip, but we're finally here. As soon as I got to the room, I dropped my bags in the first empty space I could see and set Rilke free. You really need to go on a diet, Rilke. He doesn't seem to like that idea. I stretch my back, still trying to catch my breath. I'm worn out from carrying those suitcases and this long trip. So, we're going to be living here for the next 4 years. What do you think? He doesn't seem to be loving it. Okay, changes aren't your thing and 10 hours on a bus didn't help, but you're going to have to be a good cut and do your best. Rilke looks at the room from this position, still not daring to explore it, and gives me a look of disapproval. I know, it's not like our room at Mom's, but you'll see that when I fix it up a little, it will be like home. We can put your scratcher over there near the window so you can enjoy the sun. As I talk, I move around the room, checking it out. At least Rilke doesn't seem to upset anymore. Since leaving home, I've been worrying about how we would adapt. I also promised the guy renting the room that he was a calm and friendly cat, but that's not always the case. Look, Rilke, there's a cork board. Let's start there. I open my suitcase, take out a couple of papers, and go to the desk. Rilke follows me, tangling himself between my feet. He's curious. On the board, I hang a couple of photos at Dad's old floor plans. One of the Polaroids is of me and Sophie. It was taken a couple of summers ago, one afternoon at the beach, where we laughed until our guts hurt. She's been my best friend since we were little. She's an only child and slightly spoiled. I'm the closest thing to a sister that she has ever known, and she's the closest person to me right now. I can't imagine what this adventure will be without her. The other Polaroid is older. It's of my dad and I sitting on a sofa at home. I remember that day. I had just got a new camera and I asked Mom to take our picture with it. I had almost forgotten the glasses I used to wear. I didn't know how I could have ever liked them. Finally, that's floor plan. The paper has yellowed over time and the edges are worn from frequent use, but you can still make out the design of a two-story house. Part of my childhood's memories was of my father sitting for hours on end working on that project. So near, yet so far. Looking at it, I've suddenly become sad. It's been almost 6 years since Dad died. But every time I think about it, I still feel a punch to my gut. Rilke looks at me sadly, rubbing against my calf in an attempt to make me feel better. We can't allow ourselves to be sad now. We can't forget why we're here, Rilke. I'll make my dad's dream come true and finish this project. You'll see. Today, I'm one step closer. Someone's at the door.
Are you settled in?
This is Marco. He's the guy who's renting me the room. I just met him 10 minutes ago when I arrived. At first sight, he seems distant and slightly antisocial, but the truth is, we've only exchanged a few words by mail before I decided to move here, so I barely know him.
Are you done?
Almost.
I have to leave now, okay? You have a couple of the keys in the kitchen. Oh, also, there is a few basic rules. You need to pay the rent before the 5th of the day, every month. No exceptions. Don't leave dirty dishes in the sink. And the cat stay only if it doesn't bother me, okay?
I think He doesn't let me finish the sentence.
And when you go out, don't forget to lock the door and keep the cat in your room.
Meow!
The Wi-Fi and my phone number are on the fridge. Don't call me unless something is on fire. Sorry, I can't stay longer. I have to go now. Bye.
He leaves before I can say anything else. Nice to meet you, I guess. Okay. Keep in mind that all your choices will affect the plot and the behavior of the characters. Okay. Alright. You can follow your progress in the stats menu where all the characters you meet will appear. Each character has their own unlockable nude card. To get it, you will have to see him or her naked in the game. Alright, oh wait, second. I'm sorry. I just need to lower all the things because my headcuffs are so efficient that I'm having a headache, so let's go on.
Meow!
No one said change will be easy, Rilke. Oh. You've just left and I miss you already. I miss her so much. I miss you too. I wish you were here.
Wait a minute. What time is it?
Oh no, Rilke! It's so late. I have to run to cluster 1B in time. I start looking around the room frantically for my backpack. Where have I left everything? Okay, notebook, case, day planner. Okay, I think I have everything. I'll be back in the afternoon, Rilke. Be a good boy. I grab my backpack while Rilke gives me a depreciated look as I leave in a hurry. This place is a maze. I think I've already been this way twice and I still haven't seen class 5B. I'm gonna be so fucking late.
First day.
Leaning against the wall is the guy that just talked to me. Judging by the tone of his voice, he's amused by something he's seen. There's something about him that is almost fairly in nature, dangerous. Oh well, I can't find Professor Moore's class. I think it's 5B. Can you tell me how to get there, please?
I could, but...
He gets closer, smirking like a cat.
What will you give me if I do it?
You can tell by the way he talks that he's very used to playing games and he never loses. What do you mean? I start blushing, unsure of what he means. He ignores my question. He keeps smirking as he moves closer. I feel stalked. It's like as a predator.
Although, seeing those lips, I think I've already known what I want.
I don't have time to react. He closes in on me and grabs my chin without hesitation, raising my head and placing his mouth just a few centimeters from mine. I can't move. His fingers dig into my chin and he's so close to me that my boobs are pressing against his firm chest. I can feel his warm breath. I'm full of adrenaline. My hands start shaking. I feel like I'm under his control and... I feel a slight shiver of anticipation. I have never had a thing for bad boys, but there's something enigmatic about him that turns me on. The guy slowly sticks on his tongue and runs it across my lower lip. I feel the warmth of his breath contrasting against the wet and cold trail of saliva he leaves on my lip. He is in a rush as he stares at me unabashedly, forcing my lips to open with this until I yelled, his tongue pushing and fighting against my own. I inevitably notice how my sex is getting wet, and I blush even more, embarrassed by my reaction. I can feel the strength of that he possesses, how his scent stays stuck on my skin, my breast pressed tightly between us, heaving with each breath. My mind wanders, imagining that what it might be like feeling his naked body pressed against mine, grinning, moving, filling me. I try to prevent it, but I release a tiny whimper.
Did you just moan, kitten?
He smiles, enjoying the situation and the shame it's causing me.
I hope not, or you will turn out to be even slutter than you seemed.
He moves away from me slowly. I already feel the loss of his body against mine as I'm instantly filled with shame. My instincts betraying me with how this guy makes me feel.
Now that I have what I wanted, I might as well answer your question. It's the next hallway to the right. And run, kidding, you're late. It's been a pleasure.
The guy goes away. What the hell just happened? Shit, I'm more than 20 minutes late. I'd better go to class and think about this later.
We'll be following this subject this semester.
He stops when I come in and the whole class stares at me. So guys, I don't know, what do you think about this game? So I hope you enjoyed. Comment me. Tell me what you think about this. And I will be waiting for your comment. And I hope there will be enough views to continue this, because actually it inspires me a lot. See you in the next video. Bye.